stuck in a kitten, covered in crack hoe shit. Horse intestines baked in a casserole, served to some preschool kids. Niggers, kikes, bics, slants, and gooks, let's not give them a pass. If you're insulted, I don't apologize. Suck a gay rhino's ass, and everybody sing fuck, 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 fuck.
Advertisements. They're fucking everywhere. On TV, on billboards, on the various websites you visit every day. Even in the places you least expect them. No matter where you go, no matter where you live or where you hide, they'll always find some way to find you. What really confuses me sometimes is the amount of money that some companies are willing to put in their advertising campaigns. For some reason, there are businesses and corporations out there willing to spend literally thousands and sometimes millions of dollars just for advertising their products. And when these businesses spend that kind of money, it really makes me scratch my head. I mean, it's probably because I'm a very conservative spender. I think that if you're the kind of person who spends half of a fucking $500 paycheck in a single day, then you're probably fucking retarded. I just can't wrap my head around the money a lot of people are wanting to spend in order to spread the word of a single little work. Especially when it's anime that does it. I mean, I can understand small anime and shorts like what Studio Colorado did with those two McDonald's ads. Those were perfectly logical methods of advertisement, and honestly were pretty cool. And more often than not, you'll also find lame little product placements animators slip into their works in order to pimp off a brand name or something they support. And honestly, that's perfectly valid to me too. I'm always happy to see American obesity-inducing and teeth-rotting products as Easter eggs in my anime. Product placements are a perfectly fine and logical tactic in marketing, and as long as it's cost-effective, it should be utilized as the company sees fit. Unless, of course, an entire 12-episode Japanese TV anime is produced specifically for the purpose of pimping off a product. That's pretty fucking stupid. And since the following anime is meant solely for showing off a fucking toy line, you can probably understand why I find this a little bit strange. And pointless. Well, human filth, I'm the ignorance of this freak. And this is my review of Frame Arms Girl. Let's do this shit. I'm trying to make this as short a review as possible because not only is this anime pointless, it also sucks. There's nothing really we're talking about here other than the fact that the only reason this anime exists is to spread word about a line of model kits of anthropomorphic girls called Frame Arms Girls, designed by Himekun Kaneshimada and Takeyuki Yanase. Basically, you buy the kits, paint them, put them together, and display them like regular figurines. So to put it simply, this whole thing started as Japanese otaku playing with toys. And what we have here is a collection of advertisements spreading the word of their product with Moeblog. Yay! Yeah, as you can see, my excitement is pretty much null and void. I mean, I understand wanting to inform people about something you've made, especially if you put considerable work into it. I get that. But when you look at some of the facts regarding the anime industry, I really can't even crease my fucking brow at this. The average 12-episode anime costs around 250 million yen to make on average, which is about the equivalent of $2 million, whereas a regular TV commercial costs around the equivalent of $4,000 max. The difference cannot be any clearer. Judging by how the anime industry basically amounts to slave labor where animators are practically paid a US equivalent of $4 an hour, this shit is pretty fucking retarded. Especially when you take into account all the other worthwhile and much cooler source materials these fucking surrounding animators can be paid to adapt. It all just feels like a straight up fucking waste of labor. And the feeling triples when you see that the finished adaptation itself is not all that good. I mean, the setting itself basically amounts to the life of a girl testing out these fucking sentient robotic versions of these toys. Alvinai is her name, and what little plot there is starts with her receiving a few prototype FA girls in the mail. By drone, which is kinda cool. Or maybe not, I don't know. But Al has been tasked with helping the manufacturer basically band test the combat emotional capabilities of these tiny little annoying machines. And that's basically it, plot-wise. What follows for the rest of 12 episodes is an abundance of slice-of-life nonsense in the form of these tiny little robots screwing around while sometimes undergoing the occasional battle in this holographic environment, like, thing. With extremely cheesy-ass CGI. And the comical quality of these antics? Well, most of the time it's not funny. I almost cringe at this one moment in the episode. episode 1 where Yuri goes full of talk over a pair of fucking clippers.
それでしょ?それはことぶきニッパー!
え?何?
それは至高のニッパーとも呼ばれる伝説の名品です。その切れ味はまるで日本刀のごとく、軽く力を加えるだけでプラモデルのパーツを切断。断面は平らにして滑らか。通常のニッパーで見られるようなパーツが白くなることはほとんどありません。それは刃物産地の米光によって生み出される薄い刃と必要強度の絶妙なバランスによる片刃構造によるもので、鋭い刃は片方のみにし、もう一方はない。
And also, did I mention that she didn't ask for any of this? No, this was all just dumped under her cute little lap. Basically, the company that makes these robots just randomly sent out test models to different people with the intention of having people test their abilities. To which, for some strange reason, only Al was able to do.
そうなの?適当にいじっただけなんだけど、その適当さが奇跡を起こしちゃったんだよ。
Yeah, that's not a miracle. It's an outlandishly stupid plot hole. There's no reason for this anime to exist other than to pimp off the life that's worthy of these girls. And I could tell that the staff at Studio Zex knew this very well and didn't take this shit seriously at all. The budget must have been quite low, as the CGI combat and the production quality overall here is just really fucking bad. The anime mixes regular 2D for everyone else and pure CGI for the frame arms as they spin around and act all goofy when they're not fighting each other. And when the first fight came around, I really wasn't impressed. The person that entered my mind when I was watching the first major fight in their little holographic gimmicky was... Wow, these character models look so fucking stiff. Their movements were just so clunky that I really couldn't help but stare sometimes. And I wonder if this is supposed to be a thing because there are in fact robots and are supposed to be this way. But that argument would of course become null and void when you take into account they're actually fighting in a holographic arena. And the fights themselves lack any sort of real impact or instill any feelings of danger because all these fights are basically mock battles. None of the frame arms are in any real danger. And due to this, none of them die or get seriously injured as a result. Unless of course you view damage in a little robot pride as a serious loss. And are these girls at all distinct in their personalities? Yes, very much so. That's a certain small plus, I'll have to admit. I in fact found a few of them enjoyable, but I like certain characters for reasons you would probably know that I disagree with. Predominantly I love the two lesbian sisters, or materia sisters as they call themselves, who are constantly snuggling each other like little lesbians straight out of a goddamn fucking Yuri manga. As a nerd who fucking wings up the law Yuri, I find this to be one of the anime's few saving graces. And don't even get me started on their fucking transformation. Oh yeah, magical girl has techno transformations. This anime has that too. And I hope you enjoy them because you're going to be seeing them again.
Thankfully,
the animators like to speed them up the deeper they get in the series, but still, repetitive as fuck. And what's funny is this shit's kind of pointless, as in the first episode we literally see Al putting together Yuri's armor. There was no reason for the animators to include it. So, why did they? I don't know. Because fuck you, it's sexy, I guess. In fact, I found Moe's sex appeal to be a very firm reoccurring factor here. I mean, when they're not in full armor, you see that they're not wearing any fucking pants, and often the frame just casts on the counterbalancing shot of their butt just for the fuck of it. Not to mention the opening credits of every episode starts with a shot of Yuri's ass. This is the opening for every episode I watch. Meaning literally every fucking time I open the video file after downloading it, there's Yuri's striped pantsu staring me in the fucking face. Especially when they're still wearing them, but to be the first thing I see every I start the video. Come the fuck on. And also keep in mind, stated early on by Yuri that she carries the intelligence of a 10-year-old girl.
Frame arms girl? Gorai-chan 人形とかじゃないの?
いえ、私は AS 搭載型ロボットです。
AS?
私たちに搭載されているアーティフィシャルセルフ、AS は、初期段階で一般常識と人間の10歳程度の知能が入力済みですか。
It's so gross! Can't touch it!
Now, Gretchen doesn't feel like she has that level of intelligence, because again, she lacks emotion and builds up throughout the series, but still, the notion will be pretty off-putting to a lot of people.Regardless of softcore pseudo-loli hentai, the anime itself got really annoying really fast. Seriously, the lesbian sister of the erotic transformation was the only thing I liked about this, and really the only reason I watched it for the 9 episodes that I did. Yeah, I watched the shit for 9 episodes just for the hope of seeing them snug each other again. Well, that and I guess because the interaction between these AIs is rather amusing. I mean, you've never known casual amusement in your life when you see a tiny-ass little robot kick around one of those fucking miniature automated vacuum things.Basically, watching these little robot cunts interact with each other is like the equivalent of fucking watching a dog ride a skateboard or some shit. Something special, but you just can't help but stare as it's not something you see all that often. But as amusing for as long as it was, I didn't want to watch anymore. There were simply just better animes in the Spring 2017 season that I wanted to watch. One of which advertised a product in a much better way. I mean, I like Moe, okay? Cute things are cute, fun things are fun.
Hey, you got me.
But it can't be the only factor an anime relies on.And not only is that the only factor this anime relies on, the whole thing is based on something that could have been conveyed in a fucking 30-second TV commercial. This is nothing else other than that, an advertisement. This anime relies on nothing else but Moe, and it's literally just a fucking advertisement. Nothing else, nothing more, nada. Cute little robots doing cute stupid little things in order to pimp off a boring line of fucking figurines set up in your room along with your fucking two-love root posters and your fucking gooey-ass...High school D&D document curl. That's it. And that's why I think a very fair score for Frame Arms Girl is a very lame ass 3 out of 10. And sure as hell gets, the more important and faithful poem seals of approval. There's really no reason for this anime to exist, nor is there any reason to force it on a team of animators that are probably already stressed by a fucking oppressive ass workforce. If you're going to spend several million yen to adapt something that actually has a story setting a plot of its own.Not a bunch of lifeless figurines that have no use other than decorating a fucking room. I do not recommend this anime to anyone, really. Unless you're a heavy fan of fucking Moe and extremely pointless slice of life. Or, by chance, if you're already a fucking collector of toys. But I seriously suggest that you just torrent or stream the series for free. Don't spend money on this. And if you for some reason feel the need to actually buy this shit, well, let's face it. Your room probably looks like this. And with that...If you like this video, at the very least find my ignorance entertaining and want to subscribe but or watch this on YouTube or anywhere else other than my blog, do not subscribe to me here. Share my blog instead. Links in the video description below. And if by some chance you want to support me, head on my Patreon page and donate. Until next time, fellow human filth.